All right, as I told you at the beginning of the course, Angular is a front-end framework. We build it to use client applications. In most real-world applications, however, we need a bunch of HTTP services on the server, and we use these services to get or save data. Now, as an Angular or a front-end developer, you don't necessarily need to know how to build HTTP services unless you want to be a full-stack developer. So in this section, I'm going to show you a fake HTTP service that we're going to use as the backend for our application. So head over to JSONPlaceHolder.typeycode.com. So this is the homepage of JSONPlaceHolder. When you scroll down under resources, you can see various endpoints. So we have posts, comments, albums, photos, to-dos, and users. So let's go to posts. Note that we see a bunch of JSON objects here. So each object has four properties: user ID, ID, title, and body. So when we hit this URL in our Angular app, that is jsonplaceholder.typeycode.com/posts, this is what we get. Now we can send various kinds of HTTP requests to create, update, and delete posts as well. But as I told you, this is a fake service. So let's say you create a new post. The API responds as if the post was actually created on the server. But when you refresh the page, when you get the list of posts again, that new post is not going to be there because there is no database behind this HTTP service. It's just a fake HTTP service, okay? So in this section, we're going to use this service as the backend of our application.